We welcome you to the Trinity Lutheran Service broadcast direct from the Trinity Lutheran Church here in Faribault, Minnesota. This is Sunday, April 3rd, 2016. We're celebrating the second Sunday of Easter. Our speaker this morning is our pastor, the Reverend Paul Rieger, who will speak on Peace Be With You, based on John chapter 20, verses 19 to 31. Our presiding pastor this morning is our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Michael Nerva. We will follow the order of worship, the order of matins found in the Lutheran service book. That's the order of matins found in the Lutheran service book. Hymns this morning are hymns 470, 480, and 490. Again, those hymns are hymns number 470, 480, and 490 in the Lutheran service book. Our organist this morning is Mr. Kevin Krieger. Please join us in listening or singing to our opening hymn, hymn number 470 in the Lutheran service book, verses 1 to 3, O Sons and Daughters of the King. That's hymn number 470 in the Lutheran service book, verses 1 to 3, O Sons and Daughters of the King.
Please stand. O Lord, open my lips. Make haste, O God, to deliver me. Be God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Blessed be God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Psalm 148, spoken responsively. Praise the Lord from the heavens, praise him in the heights.
Praise him, all his angels, praise him, all his hosts.
Praise him, sun and moon, praise him, all you shining stars.
Praise him, you highest heavens, and you waters above the heavens.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded, and they were created.
And he established them forever and ever. He gave a decree, and it shall not pass away.
Praise the Lord from the earth, you great sea creatures and all deeps.
Fire and hail, snow and mist, stormy wind fulfilling his word.
Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars.
Beasts and all livestock, creeping things and flying birds.
Kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the earth.
Young men and maidens together, old men and children.
Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His majesty is above earth and heaven.
He has raised up a horn for his people, praise for all his saints, for the people of Israel who are near him. Praise the Lord.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Please be seated. Our first reading comes to us in the book of Acts, chapter 5. We begin reading at verse 12. Now many signs and wonders were regularly done among the people by the hands of the apostles. And they were all together in Solomon's portico. None of the rest dared join them, but the people held them in high esteem. And more than ever, believers were added to the Lord, multitudes of both men and women, so that they even carried out the sick into the streets and laid them on cots and mats, that as Peter came by, at least his shadow might fall on some of them. The people also gathered from the towns around Jerusalem, bringing the sick and those afflicted with unclean spirits, and they were all healed. But the high priest rose up, and all who were with him, that is, the party of the Sadducees, and filled with jealousy, they arrested the apostles and put them in the public prison. But during the night, an angel of the Lord opened the prison doors and brought them out and said, "Go and stand in the temple and speak to the people all the words of this life." This is the word of the Lord. Our second reading is from the book of Revelation, chapter 1. We begin reading at verse 4. John to the seven churches that are in Asia. Grace to you and peace from him who is and who was and who is to come, and from the seven spirits who are before his throne, and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, the firstborn of the dead, and the ruler of kings on earth. To him who loves us and has freed us from our sins by his blood, and made us a kingdom, priests to his God and Father, to him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, even those who pierced him. and all the tribes of the earth will wail on account of him. Even so, amen. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is, and who was, and who is to come, the Almighty. I, John, your brother and partner in the tribulation and the kingdom and the patient endurance that are in Jesus, was on the island called Patmos on account of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a loud cry like a trumpet, saying, "Write what you see in a book, and send it to the seven churches, to Ephesus, and to Smyrna, to Pergamum, and to Thyatira, and to Sardis, and to Philadelphia, and to Laodicea." Then I turned to see the voice that was speaking to me, and on turning I saw seven golden lampstands, and amidst of the lampstands one like a son of man, clothed with a long robe and with a golden sash around his chest. The hairs of his head were white like wool, as white as snow. His eyes were like a flame of fire. His feet were like burnished bronze, refined in a furnace, and his voice was like the roar of many waters. In his right hand he held seven stars. From his mouth came a sharp, two-edged sword, and his face was like the sun shining in full strength. When I saw him, I fell at his feet as though dead. But he laid his right hand on me, saying, "Fear not. I am the first and the last and the living one. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I have the keys of death and Hades." This is the word of the Lord. And please rise then for the reading of the Holy Gospel. The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the 20th chapter. We begin reading at verse 19. On the evening of that day, the first day of the week, the doors being locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I am sending you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of anyone, they are forgiven. If you withhold forgiveness from anyone, it is withheld." Now Thomas, one of the 12, called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the mark of the nails, and place my finger into the mark of the nails, and place my hand into his side, I will never believe." 8 days later, his disciples were inside again, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." They said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. And put out your hand and place it at my side. Do not disbelieve, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing you may have life in his name. O Lord, have mercy on us. Sing to the Lord and bless his name. Proclaim his salvation from day to day. Now Christ is risen from the dead and become the first fruits of them that sleep. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Please join us in listening or singing to our office hymn this morning. Again, hymn number 417 in Lutheran Service Book, verses 4 to 9, O Sons and Daughters of the King. That's hymn number 470 in the Lutheran Service Book, verses 4 to 9, followed by Pastor Paul Rieger's sermon, Peace Be With You, based on John chapter 20, verses 19 to 31.
Thank you. like to invite the children forward for the children's message. Good morning. 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 Nope. All righty. Good morning. How are we doing? Good. Good. Yeah. It's nice to see some sunshine in the morning, isn't it? So, okay. So what did we just celebrate last week?
Easter.
Easter. Yeah. So what happens in Easter? He rises from the grave, right? We see him crucified, he dies, he gets buried in a tomb, but then he rises from the grave. And that's amazing. So today we learn about when Jesus first appears to the apostles. Now, who are the apostles? Do you guys know who the apostles are? The disciples of Jesus? They're kind of his friends. They're his students. They're who Jesus chose to have them follow Jesus. And He taught them a lot of important things, and they helped start the church. So the reason that we have a church is because of the apostles. So today, Jesus appears to the apostles, and the apostles were really afraid. Do you guys know why the apostles were so afraid? Yes. Because Jesus was dead, and they thought the Jews were going to come and kill them too. They were afraid. But Jesus comes in, he appears to them, and he says, "Peace be with you." Why do you think he says, "Peace be with you"?
Because he had to die.
He had to die. He brought peace that way. But why is he telling these disciples, "Peace be with you"? Any idea? What is peace? Yes?
I don't remember.
No, okay, lost it. Yes, sir? Not fighting. A lot of times peace is not fighting, but peace is so much more with Jesus. Because with, yes, you've got an idea. Go ahead.
It's quiet.
Quiet, peace and quiet, not fighting. Do you have an idea, or are you just raising your hand? Okay, good job. So with peace, with Jesus, it's much more than just not fighting, than just being in quiet. It's protection. Yes, you have an idea? It's love. It's so much more. There's everything that's going on with Jesus. And so with these apostles who are afraid of the Jews, Jesus says, "Peace. Don't be afraid. You're fine. I've got you." So he wants them to know that they're okay because he is with them. That brings a lot of peace. Jesus is always with us too. So we have peace too because Jesus is always with us. We know that it's going to be okay because Jesus is with us. Isn't that a wonderful thing? I think it's very fantastic. So before we go back to our seats, let's sit and pray. Okay, so repeat after me. Dear Jesus, thank you for dying on the cross. Thank you for rising from the grave. Thank you for forgiving us all of our sins. Please give us peace and be with us always. In your name we pray. Amen. All right, so please take one piece of candy and return to your seats.
Thank you.
You're welcome. There are a lot to pick from, you're right. Okay. And to the rest of you children of God, grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Christ is risen. With every Easter, we follow Christ on his journey. We stand by his side as the innocent man faces conviction. We watch as Jesus is whipped and beaten. We stand in the crowd as insults are thrown at the man who is dying willingly for them. We walk behind Jesus as he carries his cross to Golgotha. We stand and watch the Roman soldiers hammer nails into his flesh and hang his body high, we see the inscription, Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews. We stand and weep with the women and the men who mourn. We hear the insults thrown at him as he dies. We hear his last words from the cross, and we finally see him slump over dead. We see his faithful friends carry him off to the tomb. We wake with the women to go and honor the Lord's body on Easter morning, and we experience great joy because we find that that tomb is empty. Christ is not there. He is risen. And today we stand with the disciples who are terrified of the Jews and locked in a room. Today we see Jesus come into that very room and declare, "Peace be with you." After all the chaos that is Holy Week, peace be with you. In the midst of the danger of the Jews, peace be with you. In the uncertainty of the future, peace be with you. The death of Christ brings peace. The empty tomb brings peace. The very presence of Christ is peace. Now, peace is a very interesting subject in a world which is ruled by sin because it's very subjective. That means that whatever is peaceful for me might not be peaceful for you. So living among drug dealers and addicts and others in Baltimore, I was able to find peace. Being in the middle of the woods, miles from anyone or anything, I am able to find peace. Sitting with my wife, I'm able to find peace. Many out there would not find peace among drug dealers and addicts. They would probably fear for their lives. Many would probably not find peace in the middle of the wilderness. They'd be worried about, how do I get home? And sadly, there are many who do not find peace with their own spouse. They're only reminded of mistakes, bills, other responsibilities. But when we look outside of ourselves and look at our world, people in our world consider peace to be when all have weapons loaded and aimed at one another, but are not firing said weapons. That is peace. When people groups will not willingly live in a mile from one another, but are not actively trying to kill one another, that is peace. When a country cannot agree on anything politically or socially, but is not at war, that is peace. In our own lives, when we have no family, no love, but we have money, a home, possessions, that is peace. When people live with no knowledge of the true love of God, but rely on themselves and no one else and have no quarrels with anyone, they are at peace. When people think that Jesus never even walked this earth, but they have a good job and they don't actively try and hurt anyone, that is peace. It seems that peace to our world is the opposite of fighting. But for Christians, peace is so much more. Peace is Christ. Through the pain and calamity that was Jesus' death on the cross, we have been given peace. We find peace in Jesus' dead body. We find peace that he is laid dead in the tomb. We find peace that that tomb, to this very day, does not contain Jesus' body, because the Lord is risen. We find peace in the risen Lord. The death and resurrection of Jesus Christ was done so that you, me, and all people ever would be forgiven of all of their sin and stand before God our judge without guilt or shame. In us there is no guilt, because in Christ there is no guilt. We have been crucified with him. We have been buried with him. We will rise like him. And that brings us peace. There's great peace in forgiveness. When someone hurts you, it's a difficult, sometimes very awkward situation. which the both of you must face as you seek to correct the wrongs. But in forgiving one another, there is peace. There's no longer this looming, difficult, awkward situation, but only peace. And that's only amplified with God. We find it hard to nearly impossible to forgive everyone everything that they do to us. Many of us still hold grudges even after we say, I forgive you. But with God, the forgiveness that He gives us from the cross forgives absolutely everything ever committed. Every sin by every person is forgiven through Jesus. That means hatred, war crimes, violence, hurt, theft, impurity, everything else which is sinful in the eyes of God is forgiven through Christ. And that brings peace. That is peace. As the disciples stand in a locked room, they fear this world that cannot offer them peace. As they reflect on everything that has happened, as they reflect on what the Jews might do to them, Jesus stands among them and brings them peace. He shows them the marks of the crucifixion and again says, "Peace be with you." He sends them, blesses them, gives them authority, all in the spirit of peace. As Thomas hears the news in the risen Lord, he famously doubts. We tend to just call Thomas Doubting Thomas. Thomas does not find peace with idle rumors. Thomas needs proof. And while we refer to him as Doubting Thomas, in many ways, Thomas is doing exactly what each and every one of us would do. We need proof to feel peace. Thomas needs to see Jesus and touch his wounds to know the truth and to be at peace. I find this very understandable. Many of us find peace in knowing the facts and the truth. We cannot find peace in rumors or stories. We need the truth. So when Jesus appears to Thomas, he immediately offers peace to him. And as Thomas verifies that this is the risen Lord, he proclaims joyfully, "My Lord and my God," as he finds peace in the midst of his doubt. And even though we cannot touch the wounds of the risen Lord, God still brings us peace. He sends us His Holy Spirit, who blesses us with His faith. He constantly grants us forgiveness. He places His people around us when we are in need. He promises many things which we know He will keep. And through all of those things, I find peace. And I know there are many along with me. Peace to a sinner is Jesus. We find comfort and peace in Him because He has given us forgiveness. In the midst of all the chaos of the world, there is peace in Jesus. When we find that in all of the horror that occurs in our world, we can find peace in Jesus. This world cannot offer peace. This world offers lies, hurt, doubt, strife, stress, anxiety. But Jesus has come. Jesus has provided a solution for these lies, hurt, doubt, and all those other things, which will be completed on the last day. The very name of Jesus is peace. The very presence of Jesus is peace. And we, as His disciples, blessed with the Holy Spirit, are now called to be peacemakers. Jesus says, "As the Father has sent me, even so I am sending you." And while He says this to the apostles, this applies to us as well. Now, many of you are already peacemakers. You preach Christ to those who experience turmoil. You act in the presence of Christ to be with those who suffer the effects of our sinful world. You are the peacemaker of Christ as you live in His forgiveness. And for those of you not sure if you can do that, if you are doing that, if you're not able to be a peacemaker, well then do these simple things. Preach Christ, act as a disciple of Christ, and bring Jesus' forgiveness, and you will be a peacemaker. And for those of us here who cannot find peace in Christ, my advice is that you should pray that you would. I know that many times in my own life when I experience doubt, when I do not feel the peace of Christ, I find that praying to God for peace, reassurance, to help me in my doubts, to help me see truth and find peace, that I am then blessed. My prayers are answered as God blesses me with people who reassure me of God and reassure me of God's love. But brothers and sisters in Christ, be prepared. This life we live is temporary. It is a mere speck on the scale of eternity. The peace we experience now is only temporary. For the true peace is found only in Jesus. And while He is with us now, as He promises, we will all experience true peace just as Thomas did, when we are able to see the marks of the crucifixion, when we will be greeted by our Lord and our King as He greets us the very same way He greeted the disciples, saying, "Peace be with you." Amen. Amen. Let us continue on in song.
Please join us in listening or singing to our canticle hymn this morning, hymn number 480 in the Lutheran Service Book. He is risen, He is risen. That's hymn number 480, the canticle hymn in the Lutheran Service Book.
Thank you.
Please be seated. An offering for the Lord will now be received. Please rise. Amen. Amen. Remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. And give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Together, let us pray. Almighty God, grant that we who have celebrated the Lord's resurrection may by your grace confess in our life and conversation that Jesus is Lord and God, through the same Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus, and for all people according to their needs. O Lord God, Heavenly Father, we pray that you would give that peace that the world cannot give, that you would help us then to be peacemakers, that we who have been redeemed by the blood of Jesus and who have been saved for heaven would bring forth your word into the world. For, O holy and most merciful God, again this day you have taught us your word. We thank you for your continuing that preaching of your gospel for our instruction and for our edification. Send your blessing upon that word of peace which has been spoken to us, and by the power of your Holy Spirit, increase in us saving knowledge of you, that day by day we may be strengthened in the divine truth and remain steadfast in your grace. O Lord God, give us strength to fight the good fight of faith, and that by that faith to overcome all the temptations of Satan, the flesh, and the world, so that finally we may receive the very salvation of our souls. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for all the gifts of which you've given us, and chiefly, of course, O Lord, for salvation by faith alone. We pray that you would be with us and to grant us peace, and grant peace for the world. O Heavenly Father, you are the God of all concord. It is your gracious will that your children on earth live in harmony and peace. Defeat the plans of those who would stir up violence and strife and terrorism. Destroy the weapons of those who delight in war and bloodshed. And according to your divine will, bring peace and end all conflicts in the world. Teach us then to examine our hearts that we may recognize our own inclination toward envy and malice and hatred and enmity. And help us by your word and good spirit to search our hearts and root out the evil that would lead to strife and discord. That our lives may be at peace with all people. Fill us with zeal for the work of your church and the proclamation of the word of peace of Jesus Christ, that alone can bring the peace which is beyond all human understanding. Lord, in your mercy. We pray, O Lord, for the armed forces of our nation. O Lord God of hosts, stretch forth your almighty arm to strengthen and protect those who serve in the armed forces of our country. Support them, O Lord, in all things. And, Lord, be with them. Encourage them and grant them courage and loyalty, and grant that in all things they may serve with integrity and with honor. Lord, in your mercy. And Lord God, Heavenly Father, we pray for those who are in need of strength and comfort and healing. For you, O Lord, are our only help in time of need. Look with favor upon your servants and be with John and Rachel Benson and Dean Berghoff and Judy Fairclough and John Maluski and Helen Nerva and Murtis Reek and Leola Rodewald and Betty Shaw and Adele Westrup. Assure these people of your mercy, O Lord. Deliver them from the temptations of the evil one. Give them patience and comfort their illnesses. And by your good pleasure, restore them to health and give them grace to receive this tribulation with courage and with hope. Lord, in your mercy. And Lord God, Heavenly Father, we know in your holy word you do not willingly grieve or afflict your children. We pray for the family of Robert Schwartz. Be with this family in their time of mourning. Strengthen them with the knowledge that you are the resurrection and the life, and of your divine promise that where I am, my servant also will be. And be with this family, O Lord, and strengthen them and grant them power in this time of mourning. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Lord God, O Jesus, your mercies are new every morning. We thank you for this anniversary, for the 66 years of life together for Ray and Barbara Roach. O Lord, be with Ray and Barbara, and open their hearts always to receive more of your love, that their love for each other may never grow weary, but deepen and grow through every joy and sorrow shared. And be with them and bless them on this, their 66th wedding anniversary. And likewise, O Lord, we ask your continued blessing and favor on George and Gloria Cotier as they celebrate their 50th wedding anniversary. Lord, for their 50 years of wonderful marriage, we do thank you and praise you, and ask that you grant them many more years of life and love and happiness together. And Lord, be with all marriages, wherever they may be, that you would strengthen them and their relationship. For truly, as we know, here below and there above, the church is the bride of Christ, that every husband would love his wife, and every wife would love her husband, even as you love your church. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, our times are in your hands. We ask that you would look with favor on Mary Ann Young as she celebrates her 80th birthday. O Lord, grant that she may continue to grow in wisdom and grace. Strengthen her in your goodness and bless her with your abiding love all her days. And be with her, O Lord, on this her special day. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
And Lord God, Heavenly Father, We offer before you a prayer for the congregation of St. James Lutheran Church and School in Winthrop, Minnesota, whose sanctuary was destroyed by an early morning fire. And we give thanks to you, O Lord, no one was injured or killed in that blaze. We pray, O Lord, you be with this congregation, that you would help them to rebuild and help them that they again would serve you as they have in the past with a full heart, and be with them in this rebuilding process, we pray in Jesus' name. Lord, in your mercy. And Lord God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for missionaries wherever they are in your vast kingdom who stand in need of your help and who preach your word. This day we pray for Bobby and Tassini as they work with Project Video. We pray for Bobby and Tassini as they travel to many different countries working with video studios and a drug rehabilitation center. Lord, we pray for safety and for successful meetings. We offer prayers of thanks that thus far everything is going well. We pray for Burma as a new course is charted by the government. The Prime Minister is a Christian, but he is being opposed by a Buddhist majority. And we pray, O Lord, for the hostel that Bobby and Tansy run, and we give you thanksgiving for its continued support that it receives. Lord, bless this missionary family this week and grant them your sustaining presence. And help that all who hear of you as being Lord and Savior would come to believe in you. Lord, in your mercy. And Lord God, Heavenly Father, we pray for our members of the Trinity family this week. Be with Mark Burmeister and Wilmer Burmeister, be with Ginger and Bruce Burns, be with Lakeisha Burns and Harvey and Sharon Birch. Lord, be with these families of this church. Grant them your wisdom. Grant them your Holy Spirit. Grant them a furtherance of serving you in your kingdom by the power of your word. And be with us all and bless our congregation, we pray. Lord, in your mercy. Amen. For, O Lord, our Heavenly Father, almighty and everlasting God, you have safely brought us to the beginning of this day. Defend us in the same. And with your mighty power, and grant us then that this day we may fall into no sin, neither run into any kind of danger, but that all our doings being ordered by your governance may be righteous in your sight, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Let us bless the Lord. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Please be seated. We have our Minuteman talk first. Oh, you're running forward. This is Nancy Simonson. Give us the good word.
Have you heard? Have you heard? Have you heard the wonderful news about Jesus? He's alive! He's risen! And it's with that joy we have a special event planned for this afternoon for families of Sunday school children. It starts at 2 and runs till 4. This is not a come and go thing. It's come at 2. It's a vacation Bible school style. You'll come into the sanctuary. You'll hear the wonderful news of Jesus' resurrection. Then you'll be divided into 4 groups and go to 4 different centers. One center you'll get to make a tomb out of food. Another center, you'll get to create a cross. In another center, a science experiment about the wonders of how Jesus wipes away our sins. And our last center, the game center, we have stones that you get to roll through the pit of sin, through the valley of death, and to the finish line for the resurrection and victory of Jesus Christ. It's going to be fun. If you have children, you don't want to miss it. If you don't have young children, you're going to wish you did. If you have grandparents, bring those grandkids or neighbor kids. Everyone is welcome to come. It's free, no cost, and it'll be a lot of fun. Thank you.
Thank you. Don't miss our special event. Our next announcement is that more information about the St. James Lutheran A church fire and how to assist them is at the Information Center in the Narthex. Our prayers certainly go out to them. And the next mission and vision meeting will be held in the Fellowship Hall on Thursday, April 14th at 6:30. And a reminder that the Take Home in April newsletter today, and please bring one also for a friend. And also this, number five, mailboxes have been cleaned. So please check yours. I think I had that right. I can't read it, but it's something's happening with the mailboxes. Go ahead and look at it immediately. Something has happened. And also please take your flowers home with you tonight. And that being the last announcement, well, I guess we'll continue with our last hymn. Thank you.
Please join us in listening or singing to our hymn to depart, hymn number 490 in the Lutheran Service Book, verses 1, 2, and 5. Jesus lives, the victory's won. That's hymn number 490 in the Lutheran Service Book. As we come to the close of another worship service, we pray it will be a blessing to you and will strengthen your faith in Christ. This was a direct broadcast from the Trinity Lutheran Church here in Faribault, Minnesota. We wish to take this time to thank the following. In memory of Randy Trump, a gift was given by Steve and Joy Zimmerman. In memory of John Reavers, a gift was given by Emily DeLaska. Your prayers, gifts, letters, and cards are sincerely appreciated by the pastors and the members of the Trinity Radio Club who sponsor these broadcasts. Our service was conducted by our pastor, the Reverend Dr. Michael Nerva. Our preaching pastor this morning was Pastor Reverend Paul Rieger, who spoke on Peace Be With You, based on John chapter 20, verses 19 to 31. Our organist this morning is Mr. Kevin Krieger. We wish to have our listeners join in our Trinity Radio website. That's www.trinityradioandvideo.org, which we are now streaming live on the internet, our services each Sunday morning. Again, that Trinity Radio website is www.trinityradioandvideo.org, where we'll be streaming our live services each Sunday morning. We return you now to the main studios of KDHL until next Sunday at 8 a.m.